sometimes they defend their arms so tight that it's difficult to separate them. So I'm gonna teach you something that I've never really seen anybody else emphasize, but that I learned when I put in the arm raiser, because it made a huge difference, okay? Whether, if you're adamant about just turning them to the side, okay, you can also go thumb in right here, okay? Because you can create pressure, but then you can give them a little bit of business right here, okay, right across the face. Here, you're probably not gonna do as much damage choking him right here, okay? But I know that I can turn his head right across the jaw right here, okay? And it's the same thing right here, okay? Now, when you get here, I wanna grab my lapel, and my right foot is bladed. I'm not bearing any weight on my right leg. I'm pushing myself to my right onto him so I can turn his head here and lean towards his left leg as I step over here and I grab his tricep here. So oftentimes, they start defending right here because he's gonna get his arm pulled. So you have to understand that there's different stages of arm lock defense. This is stage one, when they're elbow to elbow, okay? Whether he's elbow to elbow, whether he's doing that, yeah, this, or his hands underneath, and he's trying to get underneath my leg, get this one under, this, he's here, he's trying to get under the leg, whatever. This is stage one, where it's elbow to elbow, okay? So let's say I separated, but he goes hand to hand. That's stage two, okay? I gotta get past stage two, okay? Stage three is where I, let's say, separate it, and now I have to straighten it, because he's gonna be changing that angle of that arm, trying to escape, and all kinds of stuff. So until I get past stage three and straighten it, okay? Stage three is where the arm goes straight, okay? So you have to recognize where you're at, because sometimes you get here, and you pull it, and it goes right to stage two right here, hand to hand, stage two, okay? From here, you gotta sit, together here, and now you gotta straighten it from here. But sometimes he torques it this way here, and your legs are all loose, and then he runs to the left, his hips run to the left, and then you lose him all. Okay? So, very important, what I learned is this. In order for you to really effectively finish arm locks, you have to get your lower back to the mat, not your shoulder width. Because what happens here is, when he, yep, this control here, your arm frees up, and what I want to do is, I want to put my lower back to the mat. Yeah, it torques it. Most think arm locks is this. This right here. It's not. It's getting your lower back to the mat. To get your lower back, you bow your back. Because here, my hips are driving in, okay? And I'm literally pulling him into folder, okay? Which is my hips, or your cup, or whatever, okay? Here, okay? When I'm doing this right here, it's all these lower back muscles that aren't very strong. You're here, and you torque the head like this, you have a very good chance of finishing without letting your shoulder blades hit the mat. That's a very important thing to know. And this has to be deep. If you're here and it's like perpendicular, it's not what you want. You want elbow tight, and I want to pull this to my right hip as my legs tighten here. You want extra torque? If you tuck your chin, your back is bowed, and you push your thigh into their face right here, it doesn't feel good because his head's turning left and his arms are pulling right. So all you're gonna do is you're gonna get here, your right elbow locks to your right, just pull it to the right hip. You're gonna take your thigh, push the thigh. And you're gonna get it. Now, this is just not even using two hands. What I would want to do is, as I'm going here, and I see that here, I get this. Feel it. It's up. And you're near your head. So notice where it's straight. I'm not trying to do this. I'm going here and I'm looking up. Because you know what? I need to see what's going on down here. I need to see where his hands are and what's going on. Because oftentimes, they start pushing your leg off their head right here. He grabs his collar, starts pushing the head, and you need to be able to pull. Remember, the thumb, the arm breaks the opposite way of the thumb. Point the direction of the pinky, but the thumb is pinky right here. So you have to look at it this way. If he's here, arm's gonna break this way. If he turns it this way, break it this way. If he turns it this way, I don't know why you would, but just gonna break. Okay, notice, never did my shoulders hit the mat. Okay? So just get into this position here. Dead arm real deep here, and you're gonna pull, and they're gonna go elbow to elbow right here. Okay, so look, I can just extend this leg here and just push. It doesn't feel good at all. Stage 2. See where it finishes.
Welcome back, Phil.
Thank you. All right, so look. Your hand goes all the way through, and you gotta create torque. This can't be loose. Pull to the right, here, here, push that knee here, and you can just get here, pull it. All right, 1, 2, 3. Get your lower back, so you're like this.
That's right on top.
Oh, he missed very well, just
smosh. That's okay, sorry. No, it's fine.
Yes.
Just start in the arm lock position.
Yes.